Modern battlefields are increasingly dominated by drones of all kinds, from inexpensive commercial models retrofitted with loitering munitions to highly advanced military UAVs. This new and highly dangerous class of adversary is reshaping warfare at every level. The war in Ukraine and Israel's recent interception of hundreds of Iranian missiles and drones at an estimated cost of $1.35 billion highlight the growing challenge posed by low-cost, high-impact drone warfare. As drone swarms become more sophisticated and accessible, even the most advanced air defense systems are being pushed to their limits. But what if the answer to this modern menace isn't in high-tech missiles, but in the thunderous roar of rapid-fire cannons? The resurgence of cannon-based air defense systems is proving that sometimes old-school firepower is the best solution. With modern automated targeting and radar-guided precision, these guns can unleash a blistering storm of steel, firing thousands of rounds per minute to shred incoming drones before they can strike. It is quite possible that the cure for the drone threat won't come from lasers or missiles, but from a furious salvo of lead, turning the skies into a deadly kill zone. In the face of this challenge, this very system stands resolute, capable of decimating drone swarms with a staggering 16 35mm smart rounds every second. The Skynex air defense system, crafted by the German firm Rheinmetall, is engineered to safeguard crucial assets and structures from a diverse array of aerial dangers, including drones, helicopters, and traditional aircraft. Each Skynex setup includes four revolver gun Mark IIIs, an associated CN1 control node, and the X-TAR 3D radar system designed for target identification and tracking. The Oerlikon Skyranger gun, a 35mm revolving cannon, alongside the Oerlikon twin gun, a dual-barrel remote-operated weapon platform with two 35mm guns, both boast a range of up to 2.5 miles. These can target threats soaring up to about 9,842 feet. Tailored especially for ultra-short-range aerial defense, the Skynex system uses the Advanced Hit Efficiency and Destruction, or AHED, 35mm programmable rounds. These rounds provide a more economical choice than missile-guided systems and aren't affected by electronic disruptions during launch. The current baseline configuration of Skynex provides a solid foundation for its future potential. Central to this setup is a command and control unit that connects to Skymaster, backed by a mid-range Oerlikon X-TAR 3D radar. Up to four Oerlikon revolver guns Mark III from the same lineage as those in the German Bundeswehr's Mantis system are remotely controlled. The X-TAR 3D stands out as a 3D radar system, capturing the aerial activity in a 31-mile radius. Beyond identifying and categorizing aerial entities, it transmits precise 3D data to the control unit. Here, automated threat evaluation processes this information, directing it to the weapons. Based on the mission's specifics, up to four revolver guns Mark III can be operational. These unmanned units pack both accuracy and high firepower, discharging up to 1,000 rounds every minute. They're equipped with their own sensors, like tracking radar and cameras, and can autonomously tackle targets assigned by Skymaster. Their unique 35mm AHED ammo ensures they can neutralize even minuscule threats. Depending on the missile variant, the surface-to-air missiles incorporated within Skynex can engage at different ranges and altitudes. The system can counteract traditional aircraft, cruise missiles, varied sized drones, and even ground-to-air missiles. Moreover, it can target mortars and artillery rockets with a 2.5-mile range. Beyond the powerful Oerlikon revolver gun Mark III, the system can integrate the Oerlikon twin gun GDF-009 trio, surface-to-air missiles, electronic warfare tools, and future high-energy lasers. This diverse arsenal establishes a comprehensive defense barrier against various aerial threats, ensuring readiness against mass and swarm assaults in forthcoming scenarios. The Phalanx CWIS, a cutting-edge defense system utilized by the US Navy, has earned the nickname the Angry R2-D2 due to its resemblance to the iconic Star Wars character. This formidable system is known for its ability to greet incoming threats at a staggering rate of 75 bullets per second, providing an unparalleled layer of protection for naval vessels. This is what we can call a good defense, a furious offense. The CWIS is engineered as a versatile bolt-on system with a modest working circle of 18 feet of unobstructed deck space. It requires 440 VAC, 3 phase, 60 Hz, and 115 VAC, 60 Hz electrical power, a ship's heading input, and a saltwater coolant line providing 20 gallons per minute at 30 PSIG, or 30 liters per minute at 2 kilograms per square centimeter. Although the Phalanx system is designed for independent operation, it can also integrate with the Aegis combat system on major warships. The Phalanx CWIS stands at a height of 15.4 feet and weighs approximately 13,699 pounds. Its range of motion includes an elevation capacity of plus 85 to minus 25 degrees, moving at a rate of 115 degrees per second. Additionally, the system can train from 150 to plus 150 degrees, also at a speed of 115 degrees per second. At the core of the Phalanx CWIS lies the M61 Vulcan, a six-barreled 20mm rotary cannon capable of firing at a rate of 3,000 to 4,500 rounds per minute. The 20 by 102mm ammunition for the Phalanx Mark 15 Mod O is designed to effectively bring down aerial targets, utilizing a heavy metal penetrator without an explosive filler. The Mark 149 Mod O and Mod 2 projectiles employ a depleted uranium subcaliber penetrator, while the Mark 149 Mod 4 and Mark 244 Mod O rounds feature a tungsten or tungsten alloy steel penetrator. The Mark 244 Mod O cartridge, also known as the Enhanced Lethality Cartridge, or ELC, boasts a more aerodynamic tungsten alloy penetrator, which results in an extended effective range. The velocity of the Mark 149 cartridge is about 3,600 feet per second. The ammunition handling system has two conveyor belt systems. The first takes the rounds out of the magazine drum to the gun. The second takes empty shells or unfired rounds to the opposite end of the drum. The CWIS employs a duo of radar antennas that collaborate to target potential threats. The search antenna, housed within the randome atop the weapon control group's white-painted section, supplies the CWIS computer with data on the bearing, range, velocity, heading, and altitude of detected objects. The data is then analyzed to establish whether the object warrants engagement by the CWIS. Upon recognizing a valid target, the mount swivels to face the object before handing it off to the tracking antenna when it is around 5 miles away. The tracking antenna is highly accurate, although it covers a significantly smaller area. The tracking subsystem monitors the target. The computer waits for the optimal moment to strike, maximizing the likelihood of a successful hit. Depending on the operator's settings, the system will either fire automatically or at approximately 1.2 miles or recommended firing to the operator. Usually, the third projectile out of the barrel is on target. Phalanx determines a target as neutralized when it either vanishes from the radar due to an explosion or crashing into the sea, referred to as a hard kill, or when the target experiences a sudden change in speed and direction, indicating a disruption in the airframe, known as a soft kill. Upon achieving a hard or soft kill, the Phalanx system proceeds to engage the next incoming threat. It can concurrently process up to 6 threats, ensuring effective defense against multiple threats. The US military's land-based Phalanx weapon system is an adaptation of the Navy's Phalanx close-in weapon system for ground operations. Integrated into the counter-rocket, artillery, and mortar systems, the LPWS is designed to detect and neutralize incoming threats, such as rockets, artillery shells, and mortar rounds, before they can cause harm. The system employs the same 20mm M61A1 Gatling gun that is also found on the CIWS. This weapon system's rapid response capability has been crucial in protecting US and coalition forces in conflict zones like Iraq and Afghanistan, where the LPWS has successfully intercepted numerous incoming projectiles, significantly enhancing base defense and troop safety. The US military's land-based Phalanx weapon system is powered by an onboard generator, ensuring its operational autonomy in various deployment scenarios. This generator supplies electricity to the system's critical components, including the 20mm M61A1 Gatling gun, radar units, and the integrated cooling system. The cooling system, essential for maintaining optimal performance during high rates of fire, utilizes a water chiller to dissipate heat generated by the rapid firing mechanism. Additionally, the LPWS features an enclosed control station, providing operators with a protected environment to manage the system's functions. Rheinmetall's Skyranger 30 and 35, mobile air defense systems designed to protect maneuvering forces from drones, cruise missiles, and other airborne threats. Combining high rates of fire, advanced targeting systems, and airburst ammunition, these systems provide a lethal and flexible defense against the low-cost, high-impact menace of modern UAV warfare. The Skyranger 30 is equipped with the Oerlikon KCE 30mm by 173mm revolver cannon, renowned for its high rate of fire and precision. This cannon achieves a nominal firing rate of 1,200 rounds per minute, with a rapid single-shot mode at 200 rounds per minute. It boasts a muzzle velocity of approximately 3,400 feet per second, enabling effective engagement ranges up to 1.9 miles. The system's turret is designed for flexibility, allowing integration of short-range air defense missiles to extend its reach to between 3.1 and 5 miles. For enhanced lethality, the Skyranger 30 utilizes airburst munitions, which detonate near the target to maximize damage. The turret's modular design supports various active and passive sensor configurations, including a 360-degree active electronically scanned array, search radar, and operational infrared tracking systems, ensuring comprehensive situational awareness. Stepping up in caliber, the Skyranger 35 features the Oerlikon KDG 35mm by 228mm revolver cannon. This weapon delivers a firing rate of up to 1,000 rounds per minute, with a rapid single-shot capacity of 200 rounds per minute. It effectively engages targets at distances up to 2.5 miles. The system employs advanced hit efficiency and destruction airburst munition, which releases multiple sub-projectiles upon detonation, creating a lethal cloud to neutralize incoming threats. The Skyranger 35's sensor suite includes an X-band or Ku-band tracking radar with a detection range of up to 18.6 miles, completed by an electro-optical infrared camera equipped with a laser rangefinder for precise target tracking. The turret accommodates 252 ready-to-fire rounds and can be mounted on various wheeled and tracked vehicles, offering adaptability across different platforms. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the fearsome modern cannon-based air defense systems. So what do you think about these formidable weapons? How effective do you think they are? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you are lucky enough to see one of the weapons mentioned in this video, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.